Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. It is your girl DEJHAJOY Deja Joy back in the building. I know it has been such a long time. It's been a lot going on during quarantine, and I hope you guys are staying safe during quarantine. I hope you guys are quarantining. Is that a word? We're gonna use that word today though. I hope you guys are quarantining and staying safe out there. Wear your gloves, wash your hands, wash your body. When you get in the house from being outside, wear your mask, your hairnet, whatever you have to do, stay safe, okay? So, today's video, we are going to be doing a reaction to LaToya Ebony's video. She did a video called I Try to Wash and Go on 4C Hair Every Day for a Week. Ugh, y'all. I have 4B, 4C hair, mostly 4C, as y'all know. And I could not imagine washing my hair while it's out, because y'all know I wash my hair in twists, in two-strand twists. So I could not imagine washing my hair while it's out, not in twists, and doing that for 7 days. I can't even do that for a whole day. I cannot rock a wash and go for a whole day without my hair being matted. So I'm real nervous about this. I love LaToya. I have been watching her for years. I've been watching her acting journey and her hair journey. So I love this girl, but girl, I am nervous for you. You have my love and my blessings. God bless you, because I couldn't do it. So now we are just going to go ahead and get into this video. I'm going to try to keep it short and sweet, even though I haven't been here for like 50 years. As always, I'm going to have the video posted right here, playing right here, so you guys can follow along with me. Let's get started.
Would I do this again? It looks like that. Okay, come through. Hey loves, my name is LaToya Ebony.
Hey,
if you're
LaToya.
New, look around, subscribe. I've got a ton of natural hair care videos that I filmed throughout the year sharing my natural hair care journey. Today's video is about the wash and go that I do not do normally. And I'm trying to do a wash and go on type 4B, 4C hair.
Girl, right.
For 7 days.
For 7 days. I couldn't even do it for
Where
one.
Where do that at? To
Where?
Say that I am nervous is
an understatement.
Feel free to thumbs up this video or thumbs it down if you don't like it, but I am going to take you on 7 days of wash and goes on type 4 natural hair.
Girl, I got anxiety. Oh, I'm anxious.
Let's go.
Let's go. When I look at her hair, our hair looks so similar. Like, if I knew what her porosity was and all that jazz, I would say that we were hair twins, because her hair looked just like mine. It's thick. She may have like thin strands. I have thin strands, but my hair density is there. Okay, y'all, it is thick. Y'all couldn't imagine. I couldn't imagine. But let's move forward.
Okay, so this is day one. I just washed
literally
my
how
hair.
My hair looks when it's
I
wet.
Can see
it's
some little
shrunk.
Coilies on the end. I already knew that, but I just want to show y'all. I'm gonna just do something very simple. So I've got a leave-in detangler conditioner.
Oh, y'all know that's my friend right there. That curl enhancing cream, y'all. That's my best friend right there. One of my staples.
Some coconut oil.
I do not use coconut oil anymore.
So my hair is still pretty darn wet. But I must say, the more it shrinks up, the more I kind of like it. Let's see. Kind of trying to do like a bang situation today, but we gonna see. So this is about the realest wash and go that you can get. Let me try and get it a little even now. So my hair has been dry for about an hour. I'm gonna wait a few hours. I want it to fully dry so that I can see what it looks like before I go to bed. So my hair is almost completely dry. This is it.
Oh no, 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 no. I could wear a wash and go for like a few hours. I try not to let my hair get too dry when I'm wearing a wash and go, because that matting, it's no joke. And it happens 4 hours after I do my wash and go. The matting at the ends is no joke. And I'm just looking at it, and she was patting it down.
like it. I think it looks good.
It's really pretty.
Welcome to day two.
This is what I'm expecting.
This is my hair.
Oh, it looked dry.
I have not had a chance to do
my god, no.
Lots of shrinkage, duh. Dry, brittle hair.
It's dry and I'm real nervous about washing it.
So I just finished washing my hair with conditioner and I'm not gonna lie, it was challenging. Those first 5 minutes, I was just trying to get my fingers through my hair with the conditioner applied. Detangling session nightmares.
I'm
just expecting that I could lose some length retention.
You may be bald-headed.
You know? Because my hair may not be able to survive.
That's true. Did she add products to it after? Y'all, my hair would just die. It would just be dead. First of all, I need products in my hair at all times. I need all the slip. All the slip. I need a slip and slide, okay? For my hair to do right by me, slip and slide. Day three, it looked like she didn't add any products. I know she said it was a lazy wash day, but girl, you washing your hair every day on 4C, 4B hair. Your ends are going to give you hell. It's going to be hell to pay when it comes down to detangling. I'm already knowing.
Welcome to day four, wash and go, literally wash and go. I tried to put a headband on my hair and it was dangerous. Like my hair just started getting attached. Mm-hmm. My bangs, they're not laying today. Like I accidentally did this and then they started, it's like half up and down. This is the part that I always wanted to know. The ladies who do the wash and goes, and keep it simple. What does that hair look like the next day?
Oh my god.
It looks like that.
It really surprised me how many different looks I could get out of a wash and go. I mean, this is a look with gel and having it, you know, kind of just hanging as much as possible without disturbing. Whereas when I don't use gel, my hair really does shrink up.
Yeah, because when she first started on this video, I thought she was going to be using products in her hair each and every day. The whole process of doing a wash and go when you have type 4 hair is way different than someone that has like 3C in the other looser textured hair type. It's a different process. It's a more tedious process. So I'm thinking she was going to do that process every single day while she was doing this, because it's probably something that I would have done, because I cannot live without products in my hair or my hair will dry out and it'll be laying next to me in my bed.
So I'm doing the Shea Moisture Strengthen and Restore Edge Treatment. After I applied this leave-in, I put on this thick cream from Shea Moisture, and then I coated everything.
Okay, so she's doing products.
Like, I was just trying everything because my hair feels very dry. I even put deep conditioner on just my ends. Washing my hair every day is not necessarily the best thing. So excited that this is almost over, by the way, just putting that out there. So I'm going to use the infamous Ego Styler gel, and then I am using Carol's Daughter Goddess Strength leave-in conditioner. I may use this coconut oil. I don't know how this is gonna go.
Okay,
and I have a water bottle so that I can refresh my hair. Okay, come through.
Okay, it's clumsy.
So I have a master class that I'm listening to, so I'm just gonna listen to that while I continue. You can see my hair is already starting to shrink up. It's not gonna stay like this. It's so funny because I do feel like whenever I do something that's like defining and like weighing the hair down, that it almost looks like I don't have type 4B, 4C.
That's how mine look too.
Because it'd be stretching the strand.
Mine do the same thing. If people be trying to swear up and down, you don't have 4C hair. But when your hair is moisturized and you define your curls with products, it could look like that. But your hair don't have to look jacked up when it's 4C, 4B. It don't have to look dry. It doesn't have to look matted. No curl definition. You have to moisturize your hair. And if you want a bomb wash and go, you have to add products to your hair. You can't just put water and go. Our hair type does not do that. So, yeah. Sorry to bust your bubble. Or whatever.
It's also interesting that if people see any kind of definition in your hair when it's clumped together and conditioned, that they assume that you don't have very tightly coiled.
But you know hair. Your hair tight. That was cute. Okay, they said that was cute. Oh my God.
Turn of events. I got some unexpected results. The first one, detangling. Yes, I don't like detangling every day, but it actually wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. And I think that if you are washing your hair and detangling on a daily schedule, it's not as bad as doing a wash and go, leaving it for a week, and then coming back to it. I did find that once the water kind of hit the hair and then I put the conditioner in, things sort of felt like a regular wash day.
Right, smooth sailing.
There wasn't a ton of breakage. Not like I thought there would be. I thought that I would be coming out with clumps of hair.
Breakage.
From my frustration of detangling. Like, my
fear breakage.
Was like,
you'd be breaking
all
your hair
the way
off.
Up. Co-washing is queen. Washing with shampoo every day, I do not recommend. That's why I switched to conditioner. I feel like that gives the best results. Co-washing.
That is
if I ever do this again, it's going to be a co-wash unless my scalp really needs it. Would I do this again? No,
ma'am.
Not every single day.
It ain't worth it. What you trying to prove to yourself that you can make your hair fall out?
Have you guys ever tried wash and go before on your type of hair? What was your experience? Have you done it
To answer that question, yes, I have done wash and goes on my hair. I usually put the water in my hair and then I add products. I do not wash my hair and just jump out the shower. First of all, it's gonna be a no. That's never gonna work. It's never gonna be successful. I need to wash my hair. I need to detangle it properly and add slip. And if I want those defined curls, then I need to add gel. The hair came out real cute. I didn't know. I thought as the days were gonna go on, it was just going to get worse and worse because the hair just continues to dry out as time moves forward. But it actually ended up really cute. Super defined. I just want you guys to meet my little baby. His name is Onyx. If you guys enjoyed this video and would like more, like it, go ahead and give it a like. Also subscribe. We are on our way to 30K. I want to reach 100K by the end of the year, maybe even more. But yes, it was so good being back. I missed you guys and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye. Say bye-bye. You're just gonna turn your butt towards them? You rude.